today on an all-new Dr. Phil.
They claim their biological father was part of an adoption scam.
You say he didn't want to keep the children, he wanted the money.
$3,000, you can buy a cheap car for $3,000.
I think Leanne wanted to keep some of the children, but she had someone that ruled every thought she had. And I think it was this man right here.
My mom was arrested, you weren't. But you're clearly involved.
I was involved in receiving money.
You won't believe what else he's accused of.
I just want you to acknowledge it. You took my innocence. You took my trust from men.
I can't admit to something that I didn't do.
I didn't testify against you because you scared me. I'm not afraid of you now. That's why I'm here.
Let's do it.
Have a good show, everybody. Here we go.
This is a safe place to talk about hard things.
Stand by. We'll count you down.
Today's going to be a changing day in your life. I am not giving up on you. Yesterday, I sat down with Sandy and Ava, who claimed their father, Frankie, was the mastermind behind an adoption scam that made headlines, where they claim 8 of his 10 children were sold to the highest bidder. Now, Frankie denies any involvement in an adoption scam and says he was blinded by love. Frankie says when he found out what his then wife was doing, he was told that he had no rights to his children. Here's what happened yesterday.
There she is, the woman police all over the country have been looking for. Her name is Leanne Dees. Police think she may have cheated as many as 8 women, promising they could adopt her newborn son.
Karen Leanne Dees was convicted on 1 count of mail fraud and 5 counts of wire fraud.
My name is Sandy. I was born to Karen and Frankie Dees. My adoptive parents bought me for $5,000. My mom sold me like a piece of furniture. Frankie said that when I was put up for adoption, he was actually in jail. He knew nothing about the adoption.
My name is Ava. I was born on December 3rd, 1992, to Karen and Frankie Dees. Karen told me that my dad made her sell all of those children. I didn't believe her. I want my dad to own up to being a part of the adoption scam.
Frankie says he and his now ex-wife had 10 children total, and he claims 8 of those were, in his words, put up for adoption without his knowledge. He keeps saying he knew nothing about this. I've only got 2 children. I tend to notice when one of them's missing.
Yeah.
I believe my dad played as big of a part as Karen did. They wanted money.
I need closure, and I feel like the only way I can have that is if Frankie comes clean.
I did not know that she was scamming anybody out of any money for the babies. If I knew that the FBI was looking for her, I would have turned her in.
Sandy is meeting her biological father, Frankie, for the first time right now. Tell me why your daughter is 33 and you've never met her before.
Because I can't afford it.
But what confuses me is there's so many of us. Why would you keep getting her pregnant?
And when she was picked up by the FBI, that's when I realized what was going on. Yeah. You're talking about something that happened 30 years ago.
Well, yeah. I've got a son that's 30 and I don't forget him ever.
I have never forgot him.
You say she was adopted and that you were told that you had no rights.
Right.
But were you the biological father?
Yes.
So you went to the adoption agency and you signed papers at the adoption agency.
Right.
What did you think you were doing, buying a lawnmower?
I had no idea what I was signing.
It's happened to you once, it's happened to you twice, but you get her pregnant again.
Yes.
Look how many damn babies are on that.
I know.
Look what she did to my siblings.
Are you telling me that you did not know that you were part of a baby factory time after time after time after time? You didn't figure that out.
I didn't figure that out.
And you were glad when they came and put the handcuffs on her?
Yes, I was very
glad. Weren't you just glad they didn't put them on you? Dalton says his parents put a $3,000 price tag on him and he was the last child sold before his mother was arrested.
My name's Dalton Dees. I was born in 1990 in Las Vegas, Nevada. I am Ava and Sandy's biological brother.
Dalton is my older brother. He was adopted by our uncle. Dalton lived just down the road from me, and we grew up thinking we were cousins.
I found out that I was adopted in fifth grade. My stepmom showed me the Lifetime movie, but she told me that I can't tell my adopted dad.
Yes, Dr. Weiss, she's right here. Hold on.
In the movie, the baby that my biological mother was pregnant with, that was actually me. It was kind of relief, like, because I wanted a real mom. And, like, I had this, like, weird fantasy that my adopted dad and my biological mom would somehow get together and it would be a real family. I found out that my biological parents tried to sell me to another couple for $3,000. It's like, is that really all I'm worth? After I turned 18, I went to stay with my biological mom, but she was charging me rent to stay with her, $350 per month.
That's the first time I've ever seen pictures, actually, of her this age.
And these two, it just looks like she's having all right, good time, having fun with the money that she's making. I feel like I got cheated out of a family, like, out of a life.
Well, actually, Sandy has never met Dalton. He is her brother, but she has never met him in all of these years. He's number 9, she's number 1. So let's bring Dalton out.
Hey. How you doing? It's been a long time.
Oh, I missed you.
Miss Sandy?
Hi.
Really?
Wow.
Hi. You're a lot crazier than you think.
Yeah. Good to see you.
You too.
Nice to meet you. Thank you for having me on.
Well, Dalton, thank you for being here. Frankie here has maintained the position that he has known nothing about what was going on here whatsoever. That number one was Sandy, and that she was placed for adoption, taken back, replaced for adoption for $5,000. Then number two, he says Karen disappears for 4 or 5 months, then comes back after being gone for 2 or 3 months with a lot of money, several thousand dollars. And he says he has no idea where it came from and didn't get any benefit from it, but that she comes back and then has the baby without him even knowing it, and it's gone. Then happens again with number 3, happens again with number 4, happens again with number 5, but he just never caught on, never figured out that this was like a puppy mill here,
right,
that we're turning out these children and that they're being peddled, and sometimes to multiple families. You're one of these 10. What do you have to say about all this?
Well, honestly, I feel like I've had a, you know, a rough childhood from growing up. There's just a lot of kids. Like, I wasn't fully aware of how many. I've always had a feeling that I was out of place. Kind of, it's like an unwanted type of feeling whenever you don't know where you're at.
You said you feel like a price was put on your head.
Right. I had talked to somebody, I'm not sure which sibling got in contact with me, but one of them said something about if you want to know how much you were worth to them, it was $3,000. And that kind of like made me mad at my biological mother, you know, because you can buy a cheap car for $3,000 that'll break down in a couple months.
Well, earlier in the show, we saw an old interview with a woman named Debbie Freeman, and she claims that she gave Karen $10,000 for you. So, and you knew nothing about this, right?
Right. They also said in that newspaper clipping that she had ripped somebody off up in New Jersey or Maine or someplace in that area. That's also in that same heading. Mm-hmm.
And she was doing this around the country, New Jersey and even here in L.A. Yes. And you said that you weren't part of that.
Right.
And in fact, that you had never been in L.A.
Right. No, I didn't say I had never been in L.A.
At that time.
You know.
I mean, at the time that those transactions and scams were going, right. You weren't here.
Right. But I have been in L.A. before.
But not at the time the scams were going
right.
on.
Right, right.
Okay, so when she was scamming these families for money at an apartment here in L.A., she was doing that on her own. You weren't here.
You're correct. That's right, yeah. Junior.
And then here are you.
That's me right there.
So you said you weren't in L.A. when that scam was going on, but you were.
I wasn't.
And later, if I were to arrange a polygraph for you...
If I filmed that polygraph, I'd be in jail right now.
No, you wouldn't.
Why should I take
a polygraph? You're a coward, that's why.
It's Macy's one-day sale now with great deals of the day. Like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
So your cat pooped. Now what? If you have an ordinary litter box, you're stuck with the chore of scooping or cleaning up whatever mess they left behind. Until now. Meet Litterobot. The self-cleaning automatic litter box for cats. It eliminates the burden of scooping and leaves your cat with a clean bed of litter every time. With Litter Robot, your days of scooping are over.
Over 100 million Americans have low or no credit. Self is a new way to build credit. No credit score required. Self customers who start under 600 and make on-time payments see a 49-point bump in their credit score on average. Download the app today.
Detect this. Living with HIV, I learned I could stay undetectable with fewer medicines. That's why I switched to Dovato.
Dovato is for some adults who are starting an HIV-1 treatment or replacing their current HIV-1 regimen.
Detect this. No other complete HIV pill uses fewer medicines to help keep you undetectable than Dovato.
Detect this. Most HIV pills contain 3 or 4 medicines. Dovato is as effective with just 2.
Research shows people who take HIV treatment as prescribed and get to and stay undetectable can no longer transmit HIV through sex. Don't take Dovato if you're allergic to its ingredients or if you take dofetilide. Taking Dovato with dofetilide can cause serious or life-threatening side effects. Hepatitis B can become harder to treat while on Dovato. Don't stop Dovato without talking to your doctor, as your hepatitis B may worsen or become life-threatening. Serious or life-threatening side effects can occur, including allergic reactions, lactic acid buildup, and liver problems. If you have a rash or other allergic reaction symptoms, stop Dovato and get medical help right away. Tell your doctor if you have kidney or liver problems, or if you are, may be, or plan to be pregnant. Dovato may harm your unborn baby. Use effective birth control while on Dovato. Do not breastfeed while taking Dovato. Most common side effects are headache, nausea, diarrhea, trouble sleeping, tiredness, and anxiety.
Detect this. I stay undetectable with fewer medicines. Ask your doctor about switching to Dovato.
Branch, we don't make bedding like everyone else. We make it better. We prioritize thread quality, not thread count, to make sheets that get softer with every wash. Bowling Branch is made different, so you can sleep better at night.
They said optical shops weren't very inviting, so we, Warby Parker, created ones that were. They said prescription eyewear was too expensive, so we offered more affordable glasses, contacts, and eye exams. They said opticians weren't always friendly, so we hired only the friendliest and the most knowledgeable. And finally, they said the whole experience was just kind of unpleasant, so we set out to change that too. Visit a Warby Parker store and see for yourself.
Love and Marriage Huntsville is back.
And see if Melody ever held accountability for anything ever.
With more...
Don't play with me, girl.
...drama.
You call me all the time on other issues. Do you not?
Love and Marriage Huntsville, new reunion part 2, Saturday at 8, 7 Central.
We're going to show you this hard copy episode that indicates that you were in L.A. when she was pregnant with her son, despite you saying that you weren't in L.A. at that time.
Right.
This was home cam footage that was shot by Debbie Freeman, the prospective mother, starring you. Take a look.
Okay.
This is your birth father, your dad. his name's Frankie, and he's a little weird, so...
Ain't nothing weird about me.
Now, that's home cam video shot by her in Van Nuys, California, at the time that scam was going on.
Now,
That's you on the couch, right?
That was a picture of me, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, that was a picture of me.
Shot in Van Nuys, which is L.A.
No. I came here. I worked at a motel called Carlton. It was over by a city called Tarzana.
Yeah.
Right there.
About
I worked
15
there.
Minutes from here.
Yes, I worked right there. And they had rooms that were studio apartments. And that's where that picture was made at.
Yeah, it's L.A.
Yes, I know it's L.A., but that's where that picture of me was made at.
But you said you weren't here then.
But that's where that picture of me was made.
But how can it be made if you weren't here?
If I take a picture of anybody, then I can go take a picture of you and add you right into that picture.
Not
is that possible? Is that possible or is it not possible?
Well, no, wait a minute. Is that you? Is
That's
that you?
Me in the picture. I am admitting to that.
Okay, so that they didn't add you to that video. That is you in the video.
That's me in the video.
Number 8 was sitting in her lap. That's Frankie Jr., so that sets the time.
I mean, Frankie Jr., yeah, he was sitting in her lap.
Okay, here
right
we go.
Right there, that's Frankie Jr.
Okay,
right
so there. That sets the time.
Right.
And then here are you.
That's me right there.
So you said you weren't in L.A. when that scam was going on, but you were.
I wasn't. Whenever that scam right there was taking place, no, I wasn't. I was working at that motel there at Target. Which you say is about 15 minutes from
here. Well, it's not 15 minutes from Van Nuys. It's about 5 minutes from Van Nuys. So you were there.
I was here, but I was working in a motel.
I'm happy for you. Yeah. But the point is, you were here when this scam was going on. You were in town.
Where that went on, yes, I was here in town. If that settles the argument.
And you met the prospective mother.
No, I did not.
Who was taking that video?
I don't know who was taking that video.
Does this answer your questions? Is this clear enough for you?
Unfortunately.
It's clear to me that we're never going to get a direct answer.
Well, and I feel sorry for him. But
what you want to know is, was he involved in what did he know? I mean, is that clear?
Yes.
The fact is, you have video evidence taken by the woman that was scammed of him in the apartment with number 8 in Karen's lap, and he's there. So when he says he wasn't here, there's video evidence that he was. Let's hear what Debbie told Hard Copy.
There's big money in the baby business.
I want a child more than anything. And it's amazing that people can actually scam you the way that they scammed me.
Debbie Freeman is a single woman who desperately wants a baby. When she found out she was infertile, she decided she would adopt. She took out a newspaper ad asking for a baby to adopt. Then she got a call.
She said that they needed to immediately come from Las Vegas to Los Angeles, so they wanted me to send them money immediately.
This is your birth father, your dad. his name's Frankie, and he's a little weird, so...
These people, Leanne and Franklin Dees, took Debbie to the cleaners. Debbie shot this tape interviewing the couple. One thing she found out was that they had already adopted out 5 of their children.
Debbie wound up flying the couple to California and putting them up in Dees' apartments. Debbie paid all medical and living expenses, but the couple apparently used the apartment as a headquarters to answer ads from other couples to take their money and promise them a baby as well.
But then, a month before the boy was due, a very pregnant Leanne skipped town with the unborn child.
There she is, the woman police all over the country have been looking for. Her name is Leanne Dees. Police and the FBI think she may have cheated as many as 8 women around the country, promising they could adopt her newborn son.
You have a right to change your mind when you place a baby up for adoption. They're not making it look like an adoption. They're not trying to make it look like I was trying to sell my baby. And I wasn't.
That was her. That wasn't me.
But you're clearly involved, and that's all we're looking for. Just.
But I wasn't clearly involved in receiving money.
But you knew there was a money transaction. You
knew.
Okay,
but let me see if I can help you this way. They're just wanting to tear down this wall of deceit. The truth is, Frankie, it's just not believable that a grown man could go through 7 or 8 times of getting a woman pregnant that takes the baby and shops it on the open market to the highest bidder, multiple bidders, and the babies keep being placed for adoption, and a grown man not figure it out somewhere along the way, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, at some point, light bulb's gonna come on and right. Say, you know what? I'm just keeping babies in the pipe here, right. and every time I do, she disappears and comes back with money. Right. Now, it's just not credible that you didn't pick up that pattern.
I was aware of that, yes, sir. But on baby number 6 or baby number 7, that's whenever I was told by her that this is all over with, that we're actually going to start a family.
Okay.
And I believe her.
Okay, but up till that point, you knew these babies were being marketed.
Yes, I had an idea.
All right, so you understand. You wanted a direct answer, and that is your direct answer. The question was, you knew these babies were being marketed. Yes.
Correct.
All right, we're going to meet a woman who did adopt one of Karen's sons. You won't believe what she has to say about Frankie's involvement in the adoption scam. We'll be right back.
Oh, he reaped the benefits of all of it, all the way through. He even made the statement, this can work.
He didn't want to keep the children.
No.
He wanted the money.
No, he wanted the money.
And later.
You took my innocence. You took my trust for men. And I have tried for so long to put it behind me.
I can't admit to something that I didn't do.
People gonna talk in D.C.
They're claiming the Samuels are looking to divorce.
I'm back.
And again.
Love and Marriage DC returns Saturday, January 21st at 8/7 Central.
It's Macy's One Day Sale now with great deals of the day, like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
Tap water. How come?
Well, because.
Whoa.
We're not saying Daily Harvest will change your life or that it will be the first of many steps to healthier habits, but we're not saying that. We can say that Daily Harvest takes care of food so that food can take care of you. Get started today at dailyharvest.com.
Pledge allegiance to the Black Mafia family.
To the Black Mafia family.
Pool our resources.
Take over the nation.
Nietzsche and I are businessmen.
I can respect that, brother.
We are about to turn BMF into a global empire.
Thanks for having my back.
You know this for life.
It's not subtle. Now you can give them what they've always wanted. Real food for dogs. Caesar Wholesome Bowls and Simply Crafted. Caesar, love them back.
Red Lobster's finer points of fun dining. The correct answer to starter or entree is, who gives a shrimp when you get both? Introducing new Dockside Duos. Get an individual size starter and entree for just $15.99. Welcome to fun dining.
Junk sleep have you forgetting major things? Like you're a triplet? With our mattress matcher, find your perfect match. Unjunk your sleep at Mattress Firm.
Jamaica won $1,462 for losing 101 pounds. Jack won $3,173 for losing 182 pounds. Introducing Healthy Wage, the amazing program that lets you place a bet on your weight loss and pays out up to $10,000.
I played with the calculator. I put in 80 pounds that I wanted to lose. When that number popped up, almost $3,000. Money was a huge motivator.
Money was definitely a huge motivator.
Money is an incredible motivator.
I first heard about Healthy Wage on Good Morning America and on the Today Show, and I thought, if those people had success, maybe I could too.
Lose 30, 50, 100 pounds or more.
I lost 100 pounds. I won $5,135.
Now join the tens of thousands of weight loss winners enjoying the benefits of this life-changing program. There are lots of winners every day. Don't miss out. Find out your prize and win real cash for losing weight. Make a healthy wager today and win up to $10,000.
Love & Marriage Huntsville is back.
And see if Melody ever held accountability for anything ever.
With more...
Don't play with me, girl.
...drama.
You call me all the time on other issues.
Do you not? Love & Marriage Huntsville. New Reunion Part 2. Saturday at 8, 7 Central.
Frankie says that he had no knowledge that his then-wife, Karen, was putting their children... up for adoption, their words not mine, and was definitely not involved in any scam to defraud prospective parents. Now, he has just recently, in the last few minutes, said, yes, I was aware that I was impregnating this woman who was marketing these children and coming back with money, and this was happening time and time and time again. So he has acknowledged that he did know that he was aware of that. But Dora, who adopted one of Karen's children 36 years ago, says Frankie is just as guilty as his then wife and should have gone to prison too. What do you have to say?
My son that we adopted was, I knew her as Leanne New. Mm-hmm. I never knew her as Karen. Okay, it was always Leanne, right. Is the way I knew her. And
well, she had aliases, right?
Yes, mm-hmm. But my mom and dad owned the places where they lived, okay? And, but when we adopted my son, he was actually her second child. She gave the first one up for adoption to the father of him. And then whenever my son came along, my mom and dad took her to an attorney. They could legally support her. They could buy her clothes. They could buy all of her food. They even bought her cigarettes. My mother took her to all of her doctor's appointments. Mm-hmm. Everything was paid for by my parents, her doctor, her hospital, and that she was also, they were also allowed to support her for 6 weeks after the baby was born. So we were able to, we got the baby whenever he was 2 days old, and we brought him home. When he was seven days old, she changed her mind and decided that she wanted him back. My mom told her, she said, Dora may not get to keep this baby, but I will make sure you don't because I will get DHS involved. But the whole thing was she needed to get him back because they were going to do something else. Mm-hmm. This was getting ready to start mm-hmm. because he was living with her at the time that my son was born.
Mm-hmm. No, I wasn't.
And so all of this support that was being paid was supporting her and Frankie.
Oh, he reaped the benefits of all of it, all the way through. Okay. Yeah, he was there.
He even made
the statement, this can work. This can work in our benefit.
You were actually there, yeah. Involved, watched this unfold, and you know that the money that was being paid, the support, the groceries, the living expenses, all of that were in fact benefiting Frankie.
Oh, yes, absolutely, yes.
And you say he didn't want to keep the children.
No.
He wanted the money.
No, he wanted the money. If he found him a way to make money, and to be honest, I think that Leanne probably wanted to keep some of the children. I mean, I really think deep inside, but I don't think she was smart enough to, and I think she had someone that manhandled her and ruled everything, every thought she had. And I think it was this man right here. I will always think it. In fact, I will always know it. And there's things that he says he can't remember 30 years ago. Well, my son was 36 years ago. I remember every single second, minute, everything that was done. These kids need this so bad. They need to know the truth. Their mother was very, very guilty of everything she did, but he should have been right there with her.
What do you say about what she's saying?
I don't even know that lady.
Oh, boy.
Well, I didn't ask you what your relationship was, whether I asked you what you have to say about what she's saying.
I mean, I am so sorry, but I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry at all, because you need to answer for what you did to these kids. My son wasn't even yours, and he has problems because of what has happened to all of his brothers and sisters.
Right,
he deals with this on a daily basis himself.
Your son is the one that actually came to my brother's house.
Yes.
And wanted to meet me.
Oh, he wanted to meet you, okay.
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
He certainly did.
Okay,
and let me tell you.
Says even though her biological father, Frankie, raised her, she still did not have a good life. We'll find out why next.
I just want you to finally own up to it. I couldn't testify against you all those years ago because I was... Don't cut me off. You've cut me off for too long. Don't do it.
Closed captioning provided by...
There's a different way to treat HIV. It's every other month injectable Cabenuva. For adults who are undetectable, Cabenuva is the only complete long-acting HIV treatment you can get every other month.
Cabenuva helped keep me undetectable. It's 2 injections given by my healthcare provider every other month.
It's one less thing to think about while traveling.
HIV pills aren't on my mind.
A quick change in my plans is no big deal.
Don't receive Cabenuva if you're allergic to its ingredients or if you're taking certain medicines which may interact with Cabenuva. Serious side effects include allergic reactions, post-injection reactions, liver problems, and depression. If you have a rash and other allergic reaction symptoms, stop Cabenuva and get medical help right away. Tell your doctor if you have liver problems or mental health concerns, and if you are pregnant, breastfeeding, or considering pregnancy. Some of the most common side effects include injection site reactions, fever, and tiredness. If you switch to Cabenuva, attend all treatment appointments.
Every other month, and I'm good to go.
Ask your doctor about every other month Cabenuva.
Walk with me, I'll walk with you. Down these troubled roads we've stumbled into. We're all in this thing together. We're gonna make it through. Will you walk with me? Oh, I'll walk with you. Walk with me, and I'll walk with you.
So your cat pooped. Now what? If you have an ordinary litter box, you're stuck with the chore of scooping or cleaning up whatever mess they left behind. Until now. Meet Litterobot, the self-cleaning automatic litter box for cats. It eliminates the burden of scooping and leaves your cat with a clean bed of litter every time. With Litterobot, your days of scooping are over.
So far, I've raised my credit score 39 points.
127 points.
Over 100 points using Self.
I would recommend Self to everyone.
It feels really good. You should try it.
It's Macy's one-day sale now with great deals of the day. Like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
If you ever found out that Marceau cheated on you, would you leave him?
I think that was too far.
If you thought part one was shocking...
It became a thing, a really big thing. I get ganged up on.
Love and Marriage Huntsville is back.
And see if Melody ever held accountability for anything ever.
With more...
They're both wrong.
Reunion.
Don't play with me, girl.
Drama.
You call me all the time on other issues. Do you not?
Love and Marriage Huntsville, New Reunion Part 2, Saturday at 8, 7 Central.
Real, honest to goodness, love.
Mama wanna tell you where it's at, I wanna get that.
I was made for this. Baby, y'all ready for this?
Ava says 2 days after she was born, her mother was arrested by the FBI for defrauding prospective parents, and Ava was raised by her father, Frankie. But Ava says that added up to being what she calls, quote, a horrible childhood, and she was scared to death of her father.
My dad, Frankie, molested me from the ages of 5 to 12. If I wanted to get permission to do anything, to go out and play or join the basketball team, I had to agree to perform sexual acts on my father. My dad would come into my room almost every night. I would please him while he was touching my private parts. When I was 12 years old, I finally got the courage to go to the police. They just wanted me to testify against my dad. I just couldn't do it. I was still scared of him. They couldn't convict him without my testimony, so he went free, and I went into the foster care system. I want him to know he took my innocence. I'm just angry, and it's all because I've never let this out, and I've never dealt with it. I'm mad, and I'm sad, and I'm hurt. I'm just madder than I've ever been in my life.
Well, now she's saying that there, that she's scared of me. Okay, is she scared of her mother?
Well, Ava, I'm very sorry that this has been your experience, and I'm very sorry that you've had to live with this. Is there something you want to say to Frankie?
I just want you to finally own up to it. No, I couldn't testify against you all those years ago because I was... Don't cut me off. You've cut me off for too long. Don't do it. Don't do it.
I mean, I don't just go ahead and speak all you need to speak. Speak all you need to speak.
I did not testify against you when I was 12 years old because you warped everybody that you had anything to do with. They was mind controlled by you, and you know it. I didn't testify against you because you scared me. I knew what you'd done to me. I didn't testify. But I'm here now, and you're not going to jail. I just want you to acknowledge it. You took my innocence. You took my trust from men, and I have tried for so long to put it behind me so that I can move on with my life, but I can't.
And how many times has your husband told me things like that
did not happen? We're asking about what you did. Happen.
So therefore, I can't admit to something that I didn't do.
Come on now. You're always so quick to blame somebody else. She's sitting there telling you that she's afraid of you. You said, well, are you afraid of your mom?
She's got no reason to be afraid of me.
I'm not afraid of you now. That's why I'm here.
Yeah. She's got no reason to be afraid of me.
Listen. Listen.
Yeah. I mean, what you said in that tape interview right there, that didn't happen.
What did happen?
There was nothing happened there.
Well, what did happen between you and...
There was an argument between us, mm-hmm. and there was misunderstandings between us and everything. But I thought until right now that all those mistakes and misunderstandings and everything were over. We're done.
If I were to arrange a polygraph for you...
If you didn't do it, then take a polygraph. Agree
but
to take
no,
it.
No, I won't take a polygraph.
Because you know you're lying.
Closed captioning provided by...
People gonna talk in D.C.
They're claiming the Samuels are looking to divorce.
I'm back. And all of them.
And again.
Love and Marriage D.C. returns Saturday, January 21st at 8, 7 Central.
What do you think healthier looks like? CVS can help you support your nutrition, sleep, immune system, energy, even skin. So healthier can look a lot like you. CVS, healthier happens together.
I'll remember that chapter of my life forever. We laughed. We cried. We protected that Progressive home and auto bundle day and night. We left our blood, sweat, and tears on that yard.
Well, Jamie did anyway.
With Prime Video, explore glow-ups, breakups, and mess-ups.
Do you think this is funny?
I do.
Even add on your perfect match. Prime Video lets you binge hit shows, stream live sports, watch, rent, and buy additional movies. And even add on other streamers like Discovery Plus. So much to love in one app.
Wow.
See where it takes you. Prime Video.
This is an important message for everyone on Medicare. Today we are talking about Medicare Part C, commonly called Medicare Advantage. If you don't have a Medicare Part C plan, call now because there may be plans with additional benefits available that are simply not covered under Medicare Parts A and B. That's right, there are people on Medicare but don't have a Medicare Part C plan, which covers everything in Part A and Part B, plus extra benefits in Medicare Part C. Here's the good news. If you're on Medicare, you can call even if you called last year. We will check to see if there is a Part C plan available in your area with additional benefits. If you're losing coverage, moving, or new to Medicare, call to speak with a licensed insurance agent during the special enrollment period. You don't get Medicare Part C benefits automatically, so call now for your free 2023 no-obligation Medicare benefits review. Just call 800-757-5017, 800-757-5017.
It's Macy's one-day sale now with great deals of the day, like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
Now, experience a non-invasive filler developed with dermatologists. New Rock Derm Correction Serum with our patented retinol formula. 97% had lines filled instantly and deep wrinkles reduced in 4 weeks. It's clinically proven.
Love and Marriage Huntsville is back.
To see if Melody ever held accountability for anything ever.
With more.
Don't play with me, girl.
Drama.
You call me all the time on other issues. Do you not?
Love and Marriage Huntsville. New reunion part 2. Saturday at 8, 7 Central.
Will you acknowledge that there were times that your interactions with her may have been, in retrospect, may have been inappropriate?
No, sir.
So you completely invalidate what she's saying. You're going to tell her that she's just making this up in her mind?
I'm just going to tell her that that did not happen. I don't know if you dreamt it or what have you done. But that did not happen.
The mind control, that's what I'm saying, the mind controlling. And, you know, I'm so sorry that that will always rot you from the inside out. I'm sorry that you don't want to take this time to get it out, to get it out of your body before you die. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know, if I had done something to you, I would tell you.
Just like
but
you
I have told everything else? I have never done nothing to you.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. And if I were to arrange an independent polygraph for you.
If I failed that polygraph, I'd be in jail right now.
No, you wouldn't because they can't use that in court. You've already been told all of this. Agree
but
to take
no,
it.
No, I won't take a polygraph.
Why? Because you know you're lying.
Because I've done took a polygraph on that.
10 years ago.
But
clear
you failed. Down. If you didn't do it, then take a polygraph.
Yeah. Why should I take
a
polygraph?
You're a coward, that's why. Because
coward?
You're a coward.
I'm not scared of nothing.
David, you say that there's mind control, but it sounds to me like you have a very clear control of your mind at this point, that you know what you know, and that's really important that you're very clear on what you know. Do you have any doubt at all about what you know? Do you have any doubt at all about what took place and the manner in which you were preyed upon?
No.
And you understand why I made a very specific point about asking you if you were okay with you know, being here with him at this point, because I'm very careful about putting someone in the same space with someone that that you believe has violated you in such a way. And you're going to deny to her what took place.
Yes, yes.
Uh-huh. And how do you feel about that?
It hurts. I thought I was mad, but I'm hurt.
He has the opportunity to give you some freedom here, and he's going to choose not to do that.
Because I gave her the opportunity to have the freedom whenever she made the accusations.
When I was 12 years old and they wanted me to testify, that's when you gave me a chance.
No, when I went and made the lie detector test.
That you failed.
I did not fail.
I've said what I had to say, and now I just feel sorry for you. I really do.
You feel sorry for me or whatever, and I know what happened. I know the truth, and that's all that's important to me.
If you can go to your grave like that, then I just feel bad for you. I went through all the stages of this, and now I just feel bad for you.
Well, I mean, you can feel bad for me if you wish.
Is there anything else you need to say to him at this point? Is there anything else you want to say at this point?
No, sir.
All right, well, we're going to take a break, and I'm going to excuse Frankie. We'll be right back.
People going to talk in D.C. They're claiming the Samuels are looking to divorce.
And again.
Love and Marriage DC returns Saturday, January 21st at 8, 7 Central.
When you're ready to go, but static says, whoa. Try Bounce Lasting Fresh Dryer Sheets. More freshness, more softness, less static, less wrinkles. Yeah, it's the sheets. New Bounce Lasting Fresh Dryer Sheets. It's the sheet.
It's Macy's one-day sale now with great deals of the day. Like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
Daddy printed out my permission slip, right?
Steven?
Do you suffer from cartridge conniptions? Be conniption-free thanks to the cartridge-free Epson EcoTank printer. Big ink tanks, a ridiculous amount of ink. The Epson EcoTank, just fill and chill.
Fair, freckled, or melanated, we are appreciated. Ultra-hydrated, glazed, and glowing. Confidence overflowing. New Vaseline lotions, 90% more moisture for my one-of-a-kind skin. And there's no other skin I want to be in.
He always went for bad debt.
We had a lot of expenses. The intro offers were hard to pass up.
Then the interest payment started.
The debt just kept getting worse. So we broke up with bad debt and got a low fixed rate SoFi personal loan for our big expenses.
And the couch goes back tomorrow.
Break up with bad debt. Fund weddings, home renovations, or consolidate debt. View your rate at SoFi.com. SoFi, get your money right.
What do you think healthier looks like? CVS can help you support your nutrition, sleep, immune system, energy, even skin. So healthier can look a lot like you. CVS, healthier happens together.
Baby, you're a perfect 10. I want to get in. Can I get down so I can do? I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Bag it up.
I like the way you work it.
Sure, you'll teach her how to drive a car, then use Greenlight to power her independence with crash detection with 911 dispatch, family location sharing, and emergency SOS alerts. Invest in your best investment with Greenlight.
Were you diagnosed with ovarian cancer or mesothelioma after regular use of talc products? Call 1-800-900-9260. You may be entitled to significant compensation. Talcum powder manufacturers failed to warn customers of cancer risks, leading to billions awarded to cancer victims. If you were diagnosed with ovarian cancer or mesothelioma after using talc products, call the Driscoll Firm at 1-800-900-9260 right now.
Real, honest to goodness, love.
Mama wanna
tell you where it's at. I wanna get that.
I was made for this. Y'all ready for this?
I'm back with Sandy, Ava, and Dalton. And Dora, I ask you to take a seat in the audience here so I can just talk to the kids. Thank you so much for being here today, and thanks for the clarity of your voice. It's people like you, Dora, that make a big difference and restore my faith in human nature. I ask Frankie to leave because I wanted to speak to the three of you. Ava, I don't know what all has happened with regard to the system and foster care and that sort of thing. Robin and I are national spokesperson for CASA, court-appointed special advocates, so we work a lot, Robin in particular, with the foster system, and we know it's a broken and imperfect system, so I can only imagine what kind of turmoil that it's put in your life. And I'm sorry for that. I believe every word that you're saying.
I want to take a polygraph.
You don't need to.
And that's bad. I want to take a polygraph.
You don't need to take a lie detector. If you want to take a lie detector, I'm happy to arrange one for you, but I am a lie detector, and I'm telling you, I believe you fully. If you want the piece of paper, I'm happy to arrange it for you, but I don't think that anyone doubts what you're saying. You know, there are certain clinical signs and elements for people that have been raped, molested, and assaulted that just simply can't be faked, and if they're absent, they're absent, and they can't be mimicked in any way, and sadly, they're very clear with you, and I'm sorry for that. And I don't know what all's happened in the system, but if no one in the system or in that generation has ever stepped up, looked you in the eye, and said they're sorry for what's happened to you and the manner in which the system has failed you, then let me be that person to step up and say, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. You know, it's happened to you, Dalton, and as you said, you've had a tough go of it, as you have. And look, not even God can change what has happened, but we can certainly work on what is going to happen. And what I would like to do is offer to get involved in arranging really good, solid, specialized intervention with this family to help you guys professionally. And Ava, for example, with you, there's a very specialized care that's necessary to heal the wounds for someone that's been through. It's not just your garden variety therapist. There are those that specialize in that kind of trauma, surviving what you've survived, and I want to arrange that kind of specialized help for you to help you get a handle on this and heal those wounds and put it behind you.
Closed captioning provided by...
People gonna talk in D.C. They're claiming the Samuels are looking to divorce.
I'm back.
Again.
Love and Marriage DC returns Saturday, January 21st at 8, 7 Central.
Oh, Miss Flores, what will we do without you? Leader of many and pet wrangler too. You report to your boss every afternoon.
So beautiful.
So becoming a student again might seem impossible. What if a school could be there for all of you? Career, family, finances, and mental health. Well, it can. National University, supporting the whole you.
So your cat pooped. Now what? If you have an ordinary litter box, you're stuck with the chore of scooping or cleaning up whatever mess they left behind.
Until now. Meet Litterobot, the self-cleaning automatic litter box for cats. It eliminates the burden of scooping and leaves your cat with a clean bed of litter every time. With Litterobot, your days of scooping are over.
Pledge allegiance to the Black Mafia family!
To the Black Mafia family!
Get in the game or stay out of it.
I already told you. I'm out.
My sons did not come from a broken home. They came from a broken city.
I don't know who to trust in this family anymore.
You better stick together no matter what.
Thanks for having my back.
You know this for life.
Over 100 million Americans have a low credit score. Self is a new way to build credit that doesn't require a credit score. Plus, Self helps you save money every month and reports your payments to all three credit bureaus. Download the app today.
It's Macy's one-day sale now with great deals of the day, like up to 65% off coats, 40% off designer booties and handbags, and up to 70% off luggage sets. Plus, get it faster with curbside pickup at Macy's.
Dad and I finally had that talk.
No, not that talk.
About what the future looks like.
For me, I may have trouble getting around, but I want to live in my home where I'm comfortable and my friends are nearby. I can do it with the help of a barber, personal shopper, an exercise buddy, someone who can help me live right at home.
Life's good
when you have a plan.
Love and Marriage Huntsville is back.
And see if Melody ever held accountability for anything ever.
With more.
Don't play with me, girl.
Drama.
You call me all the time on other issues.
Do you not? Love and Marriage Huntsville, new reunion part 2, Saturday at 8, 7 Central.
I don't know what kind of internal dialogue the three of you have, but I can imagine that it's not positive. I can imagine that the things you say to yourself. You know, we all have a personal truth. You know, things we say to ourselves and believe about ourselves when nobody else is listening and nobody else is looking. Not our social mask, what we really believe about ourselves inside. And the problem is we generate the results in life that we believe we deserve. So if we have a damaged personal truth, if we think we're damaged goods, if we think somehow we're second class, then we'll go through our lives generating the results that we think we deserve. And I think I'm sitting here with three people that have damaged personal truths. I don't know how you couldn't. And until those damaged truths are repaired and healed, you're going to continue to generate the results that go along with being damaged. And I want to help you repair what you believe about yourselves, repair the psychological damage that's been done so you can begin to reach for what you deserve in this life instead of what you believe you now deserve in this life. And that's going to take some time and it's going to take some care, but I have really good resources and I'm offering to make them available to the three of you beginning right away, right now. Okay? So if you'll let me do that, then I want to begin to make those arrangements for y'all.
Thank you.
Immediately.
Yes.
Okay. And we at least got Frankie to acknowledge a whole lot more than I think you ever thought he would acknowledge today. Yeah. And sometimes you have to give yourself what you wish you could get from somebody else. Sometimes you have to look in the mirror and say to yourself what you wish you could hear from somebody else. And hopefully that's what we can begin to learn to do going forward.
Thank you.
I'm proud of the three of you for coming here today and doing this. I want to thank all of my guests today. We'll see you next time. Thank you so much.